Good morning, students. I am Manikant Mishra. Today, Modern English School, New India. Today, I am going to discuss that is how we can convert the one physical state of a matter into another physical state of matter. I mean to say that how do we convert the solid state of matter into liquid state and liquid state to gas or gas to solid, solid to liquid, liquid to gas or vapor, gas to solid. So by changing the temperature, by changing the pressure or by changing the temperature and pressure, we can convert the one form of solid into another form of solid. Like the minimum temperature at which the solid convert into liquid state at one atmospheric pressure is called melting or fusion. Now the minimum temperature at which liquid change into vapor form at one atmospheric pressure is called boiling or boiling point. Now, so in these two cases, there is a need of temperature, heat energy, sorry, heat energy is required. By changing the temperature, by giving the heat energy, then solid converts into liquid or liquid converts into vapor. But gas, carbon dioxide gas can be converted into solid carbon dioxide. Often we call it as a dry ice. Is converted by changing the temperature as well as by changing the pressure. Then the solid gaseous carbon dioxide can be converted into the solid carbon dioxide. Now let us do these things with one activity. Take a beaker, and in a beaker you take a few crystal of ice and put it on a gas burner and let the burner on. And insert a thermometer in a beaker. What happens after 5 minutes, if you read the temperature on a thermometer, then it shows 0 degrees Celsius. Make sure if water is pure. Now if you put the beaker containing ice on a gas burner, sometimes A to B the temperature do not change, though you are continuously heating, yet the temperature remains constant. So why the temperature is a constant, or why this heat energy has gone? This heat energy is hidden. So this hidden heat energy is called latent heat. So now latent heat is what? Hidden energy which requires at point A the ice is at solid state. At point A the ice is at solid state, but at B whole ice melts. So it means A to B is a transition state. What is a transition state? Here solid change into liquid. So it means all the heat energy is involved in changing the state of matter from solid to liquid. This latent heat is called latent heat of fusion. This is called latent heat of fusion. What is latent heat of fusion? The amount of heat energy required to convert unit mass mass of solid into liquid below its melting point without any change of temperature at one atmospheric pressure is called latent heat of fusion. And latent heat of fusion of ice is equal to 3.35 into 10 to the power 5 joule per kg. This value is called latent heat of fusion of ice. It means in 1 kilogram of ice, in order to convert into 1 kilogram water, this much heat energy is required. Now, all the ice has already melted and in the form of liquid, so slowly the temperature increases on a thermometer. At point when the thermometer temperature reaches at 100 degrees Celsius, then water starts to boil. This point is called boiling point. Once again, if you continuously heating, yet temperature remains constant. Now, on the thermometer, temperature do not increase, remains constant, that is at 100 degrees Celsius. Once again, where the temperature has gone? Where this heat energy has gone? So, here, this again, C to D is a transition state. Changing of the state, one form of the state is converting into another form of state. Like here, water is in a liquid state, but here at point D is in the vapor state. So all the water at D, all the C to D is a transition state. It means the liquid convert into vapor form. So all the heat energy is used in order to convert the state of matter, and this is called latent heat of vaporization. That energy which is involved in order to convert liquid into vapor is called latent heat of vaporization. And latent heat of vaporization of water is equal to 2.26 into 10 to the power 6 joule per kilogram. Latent heat of vaporization of water is equal to 2.26 into 10 to the power 6 joule per kilogram. What does it mean? If you want to convert 1 kilogram of water into 1 kilogram vapor, then this much heat energy is required, which is equal to 2.26 into 10 to the power 6 joule. So this is called latent heat of vaporization. One more thing I would like to focus here itself. Since water starts to boil at point C, but continuously you are heat supplying the heat energy, and those energy takes the water molecules and converts into vapor form. It means vapor or that steam or vapor has a more energy at same temperature at 100 degrees Celsius as compared to 100 degrees Celsius of water. It is the reason that burning with steam at 100 degrees Celsius is more painful as compared to 100 degrees Celsius water. Thank you. Have a nice day.